Namaste. The human body has been one of the most studied topics in the history of science. Since the ages of Ayurveda Acharyas, the description of the anatomical aspects of the body has prevailed. Welcome. Today, we shall go through certain aspects about the Sharira and Sharira as explained in Ayurveda. By the way, fun fact, Ayurveda Acharyas also gave a detailed understanding of the various layers of the skin and the pathology of diseases in the respective layers without any kind of assistive imaging or any other techniques in their times. These details are very much in sync with the modern understanding of the skin. Starting with the first aspect of our study in today's video, Sharira. Simply put, Sharira is nothing but the sthula deha, that is, the objectively perceivable body. To understand Sharira in detail, let us first look into the origin or derivation of the term Sharira. There are three references which state the origin of the word Shr dhatu plus Iran pratyayah, where Shr dhatu means himsayam, which means violence, that is to hurt or destroy. According to the Garbhopanishad, the term Sharira is told to be derived from Shri dhatu, which means Shrayane, meaning to depend on. Finally, Acharya Yaska, who was a famous Sanskrit grammarian, mentions that Sharira gets its origin from the root word Sham. Coming to its definitions, Shiryate iti Shariram. Shiryate pratikshanam apachiyati iti Shariram. Sharira is that which undergoes destruction continuously. That is, that which is getting destroyed every moment. Shiryate hinasti atmanam iti Shariram. Sharira is that which is abandoned by the Atma, whereon the Sharira is the ashraya for the Atma. Tatra Shariram nama chetana adhishtana bhutam pancha mahabhuta vikara samudayatmakam samayoga vahi. Sharira is the observable form of the body formed by the pancha mahabhuta vikara and acts as the adhishtana for the chetana or the atma. To substantiate the above definition, let us look into the following shloka. Panchanam mahabhutanam vikara rasadayaha sharirarambhakaha. This states that the variations of the quantity and quality of the panchamahabhuta called panchamahabhuta vikara forms the rasadi dhatu. Let us now look into the different synonyms of the word sharira. Tanu, samhananam, kalevaram, vigraha, deha, kaya, angam, vapuhu, puram, pindam, kshetram, gatram, murtihi. The word Sharira has been famous throughout all texts of Ayurveda. A natural question arises as to, you know, why such a negative connotation, that is one which is continuously destructing, has been used to describe the human body, right? Why haven't other terms which represents the physical body like Kaya or Anga or Murti used more often in the texts of Ayurveda? Have you ever thought about this? Tell us your thoughts by commenting on this video. Let us now talk about the term used for the study of Sharira, that is Sharira. Acharya Arunadatta has described Sharira as Sharira Madhikritya Krito Grantha Sharira, which means the text that deals with the complete knowledge of Sharira, that is both the structural and functional aspects. शरीरं चिन्त्यते सर्वं दैवमानुष संपदा सर्वभावैः यतस्तस्मात् शरीरं स्थानमुच्यते. According to Acharya Charaka, all the divine human resources pertaining to Sharira, that is, the body, its components, their structures, their numbers, their normal proportions, size, shape, mutual relationships, and the functions they serve, is explained in the best possible way in Sharira Sthana. Here the term Daiva represents metaphysical aspects and the term Manusha represents the physical aspects of the body. Isn't that interesting? Ayurvedic anatomy and physiology is not just limited to the laws of known physics and to biochemistry. It deals with facets of science that are not explained by the minds of our modern generation. Acharya Vagbhata too has explained that Sharira Sthana is that part of the text wherein Janma and Marana is detailed. This is a valid point wherein even Rishta Lakshanas are mentioned in Sharira Sthana of Ashtanga Hridaya. So what is the need of studying Sharira in Sharira Sthana? Shariram Sarvatha Sarvam Sarvada Vedayo Bhishak Ayurvedam Sakatsnyena Veda Loka Sukhapradam. Acharya Charaka describes that the physician who is always well versed with the various aspects of Sharira is highly proficient in Ayurveda and therefore can bring about happiness or Sukha to the universe. As we are explaining about Sharira in this video, it is important from the perspective of Ayurveda that we learn in brief about Shariri too. Shariri is a Sanskrit word referring to the entity which resides in the Sharira. Shariri is commonly represented by the term Atma and is one among the Navakarana Dravyas. The word Atma is derived as At Dhatu, Ata Sa Tatmya Gamane. That which has continuous motion is called as Atma. Atma is the Adhishtana or the seat of knowledge, that is Jnana. Atma though is a Dravya, it cannot be perceived through the Pancha Jnanendriya. But Aptopadesha and Anumana Pramanas prove the existence of Atma. Do watch our video on Atma to learn in detail about the concepts of Shariri. To summarize, the final take home points here. Sharira is nothing but the human body, made of the Pancha Mahabhuta Vikara, acting as the Ashraya for Atma or the Chetana. Sharira is the text or the science which deals with the study of Sharira, the human body, in detail. This includes the anatomical and physiological aspects of the Sharira, including conditions from Garbhavastha to Marana. Shariri refers to the Atma itself, which is the Ashrayi, one which takes shelter of the Sharira. Appreciate our work? Hit the like button to support us and comment with your opinions. Subscribe to this channel and share with your friends. Follow us on Instagram and Facebook for more updates. Thank you very much.